Okay, continuing with pasta at home, what we're going to do today is we're going to make some ravioli. And instead of making the dough and cutting it out, which is a bit of a process, it's a lot of fun actually if you have time and the room, it's fun to make with kids. But we're going to cheat and we're going to use these wonton skins.
They're just very thin, they're all very uniform. I like the round ones better than the square ones, but you can use either one. So what we're going to do is we're going to make the filling for the ravioli. I'm going to add a little bit of a ricotta cheese here. I'm going to add a little bit of egg, maybe about half an egg. And sometimes you see these recipes where it calls for half an egg. People always wonder where they come from. It's, you know, when they do those grilled half chickens, they get the half an egg for them. I'm just going to mix that up a little bit, add a little salt, and a little bit of pepper. That's really all you need. And what we're going to do is we're going to fill these wonton wrappers with a little bit of the if you really want to go crazy, what you can do is you can make your own ricotta cheese, which is very easy. And basically it's about a half a gallon of milk, a third of a cup of lemon juice and a third of a cup of white wine vinegar. And you bring the lemon juice, bring the milk to a simmer, and then all you're going to do is you're going to take it off and add the lemon juice and the vinegar, let it sit and strain it out. And what you're going to do is you're going to brush a little bit of beaten egg around the outside of the ravioli, and that's going to help the ravioli stick. So we'll take another one. Place it on top, press it down nicely, make sure all the air's out of there as best you can. And you have your own handmade ravioli. And again, you can fill these with whatever you want. There's all kinds of different fillings. We use shrimp, we use butternut squash and pumpkin in the fall, short ribs, which will be on the menu actually pretty shortly. As soon as we get open, we'll do a little short rib ravioli. So I'm just going to brush these up. Bubbles out. Press that down. Six ravioli. So what we're going to do with these, we're going to take these, we're going to put it in boiling water. What happens now, when they're done, they'll float to the top. While that's going on, we're going to make our sauce, which is basically just brown butter, a little fresh sage. I'm going to add a little bit of white balsamic vinegar in there just for a little tart angle. That's going to be it. So we're going to take our butter in there. Taking some sage, fresh sage, and peeled it off the stems, and we're going to rough chop it. You don't really have to get crazy with this.
that right in. You just want that on the flip. You want the brown light. You don't want to burn it. What's happening is the milk solids are starting to brown. You can see that. Raviolis are almost done, some of them are floating. I'm going to add a little bit of salt to that. I'm going to add just a tiny, tiny bit of balsamic hitchhiker on there.